Let's look at one of the most important lessons in Carnatic music, which is the Varnam in Mohanam. Mohana Varnam is one of the first that is taught to students when they get to the Varnam stage. Reason is that it's a very simple composition. Second thing, it's also a very popular composition. Third thing is that it can be a very attractive concert piece also. So mastering the Mohana Varnam will give many advantages to the student. So for the introduction in Mohanam, you can always learn the Gitam first nicely and then go to the Varnam. This Varnam is by Ramanathapuram Srinivasa Iyengar, who was also known as Poochi Srinivasa Iyengar. All Varnams are in the third speed. The primary speed that Varnams are composed in is third speed. That means for every beat we'll have four notes. So, Mohanam is a very simple sounding raga, just five notes. So, technically it can be listed under four different Melakartas: Harikambodhi, Shankarabharanam, Vachaspati or Kalyani. Of the lot, some books and authors follow the convention of listing it under the first possible of these four, of which Harikambodhi would be there. So that means it will be listed as the Janyam of the 28th Melakartha Harikambodhi. But if you go to a slightly advanced perspective, you can see by the characteristic way in which the notes are handled, how the oscillations are given in which kind of notes. From that perspective, Kalyani would fit the bill, because all the notes that you see in Mohanam that can be oscillated in Kalyani also. Ga, Da, Ri, all these can be oscillated in Mohanam and Kalyani. The Ga would be plain in Raga like Harikambodhi or Shankarabharanam. So, Kalyani would be a better fit for Mohanam. But this does not mean that when we render phrases like Sadapa, we have to suggest Ni, or when we render phrases like Pagari, we have to suggest a Ma. We have to, in fact, take care not to suggest Ni and Ma when we sing Mohanam. How do we do this? So, immediately bring your voice down to Da. Can also be done, but still you are taking it from Sa to Da. But if you render two Sa's, if you do that, make sure that the second Sa is taken from Da. Kind of thing. If you do that, then the Ni and Ma will be suggested. So, in ragas which do not have Ni and Ma, make sure that the Spuritam if you are ever using that kind of phrase, you have to use it like that. Better to always try to render only one Sa and one Pa. Avoid double Sa and double Pa in Mohanam as much as possible. Kind of thing should be avoided. Even though it will be heard plenty, we have to try and avoid, take care in that kind of phrases when we are handling ragas like Mohanam. So now let's look at some introductory phrases in this raga.
Gapagarisa.
So in that kind of phrase also, should be avoided. Oscillate the ga minimally, otherwise it will sound like mapa. Will sound like kind of thing. So same thing for even if you take it from sa, finish the oscillation minimally. Don't do that. Let's look at the notes of the Pallavi. Yeah, here some people might sing it as sa re re ga ga re re. Moment you see these two notes, the same note happening twice, we don't have to always be forceful only about it. So in advanced level, we have to sometimes even choose elegant ways of singing that. So there's no ornamentation at all on that sa sa. Sa sa re re oscillation. Sa sa re re ga ga. Again, no ornamentation there. Re re, that's all. Let's try that. Sa sa re re ga ga re re.
Sa re ga re re.
Sa re ga re.
Sa re
sa
da.
Sa re ga pa ga re sa re.
Sa re ga pa ga re sa re.
See how I'm connecting the ga and pa. Sa re ga pa ga re ga pa ga re will be very scientific way of singing it just straight. But for artistic reasons, we'll connect that ga and pa. Sa re ga pa ga re sa re. Then next line. Ga pa ga ga re sa.
Ga pa ga ga re sa.
Re ga re re sa da.
Re ga re re sa da.
Sa re ga re.
Sa re ga re.
Ga pa ga pa da pa.
Ga pa ga pa da pa.
Da sa da da pa ga.
Da sa da.
Da pa ga re.
Da pa ga re.
So that is the tune of the Pallavi. Let's sing it once together.
Ga ga re re sa sa re re ga ga re re sa re ga re sa re sa da sa re ga pa ga re sa re. Ga pa ga ga re sa re ga re re sa da sa re ga re ga pa ga pa da pa da sa da da pa ga da pa ga re.
Then let's look at the Anupallavi.
Ga ga pa
ga ga pa.
So here I'm giving a small spuritam on the second ga.
Ga ga
like that.
Ga ga
pa ga ga pa da da pa
ga
This is basically the way to sing Gari Fedasa itself. That's what will be written in many books also. You have to give it force from the ga. So what I have done in this book, Perfecting Carnatic Music Level 2, is almost put it little more blatantly as ga gari sa dasa. The same as re sa da ba da. That will be there in some books. Or re sa da ba da, if you have to give a force when you are singing the sahityam. So you can imagine it as gari sa da sa rika da ba da, or as what is written in this book. But the way of singing that, when you are singing lyrics, that is what really matters. So So let's sing the whole Anupalavi tune. So once you have finished learning this tunes properly for both Pallavi and Anupallavi, then try the Sahityam.
Ninnukori 1, 2, 3, 4.
Yeah, don't be half-hearted about oscillating the commas. When you see four carvais in that means the re plus three commas, you see, right, in that place, be clear about the tempo of that oscillation that you have to give in these kind of places. Only then the song will sound structured. Ninnukku kind of thing, if we do, we will also not be clear about the number of units in that, nor will the listener be. And second thing, that wholesomeness of listening to that note will be lost if the oscillation is not as it should be. When the oscillation has to be minimal, make sure you are only giving minimal oscillation. If the oscillation has to be strong, make sure that you are doing that all the time. Ga ga ri ye 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 ninnu ko go go has to be there very clearly. These are all very important points when we learn a new composition and when we render it each time. Let's try that. Yeah. So 1, 2, 3, 4 each time from the ga. Go 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 go. Re. So see how I'm singing that akaram for that, or ikaram in this case. Re ye 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 ye. I'm not doing re ye 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 ye. I'm not doing that. Re ye 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 ye. Yun. So when you are doing that phrase going all the way down to da, that note should be heard. You have to see whether that note is being heard. Not only by ourselves, But are we actually singing clearly enough for other people to hear it? We have to hold that note a lot of time so that our voice gets settled there, even when we sing it for a fraction of a moment. That's the key. Otherwise, it'll just sound like that. And we'll be claiming that we sang it, but others won't have heard it. And there could be arguments between student and teacher or parents, whether you sang it or you didn't sing it, whether you heard it, all these things. The key is we have to sing it so clearly that everybody should be able to hear it. Hear all the notes. It's a simple enough thing, but unless we practice, we won't get that simple thing right. So, lower octaves, higher octaves, whichever the octave, whatever the range, we have to practice it so that the note is heard, number one. Second thing, we have to make sure that we stay on that note so that our voice gets sweet in each one of those notes. Otherwise, it will still sound, kind of thing. The sweetness won't be there. So, for sweetness to develop, we have to stay on these kind of notes. Try. And then see if you can sing it in the tala. So, that is the way to practice this.
No, yeah.
Some books might give that yeah slightly off by another note. Sometimes this kind of small spacing differences could be there between version to version. That's not too bad as long as the overall meaning of the words are clear and we sing it. And the way the syllables are not overstretched or overshortened. Okay? Let's sing the whole Pallavi once.
Ninnukori.
Let's look at the Anupalavi. If you notice there, I sang it more like for that one. But you can also sing it as if you want. Both are right. Okay. Now let's look at the Mukta Swaram. So even though the note is written as just gapadapa, there is a small hidden sa over there. Gapadapa, and also the da before the pa. Gapadapa kind of thing. Gapadapa.
Gapadapa.
Gapadapa
desa
diga.
Gapadapa desa diga.
Diga. So how I'm connecting that sa from that ga itself, which is the previous note, the last note of the previous phrase also. That sa to pa should be very clear. So that's all part of voice culture. So
riga sa di da sa pa da. Riga sa di da sa pa da.
Sa di ga sa.
Sa di ga sa.
Da pa.
Da pa.
Ga re sa re.
Ga re sa re.
Ga. Gare sa re sa re sa gare ga sa re sa da sa re ga re ga pa ga pa da pa ga pa da pa da sa di ga re ga sa di da sa pa da sa di ga sa da pa gare sa re Ninnukori stop like that, tunefully in that. Now if you notice, I also sang the second speed, that is the double speed of the Varnam. Even that, each section has to be sung two times. Pallavi has to be sung two times, and then Anupallavi two times, and then that Swaram also has to be sung two times. But before going to the second speed, practice the first speed, nice section by section, the way I have taught it. Then let's look at the Charanam now.
Ga 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 pa ga re.
Ga 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 pa ga re.
Re ga pa ga.
Re ga pa ga.
Pa.
Pa.
Pa ga da da pa.
Pa ga da da pa.
Again, see that the how I am handling the two da's with a minimal oscillation both times.
Pa ga da da pa. Pa ga da pa,
pa ga da pa,
ga pa ga re sa re,
ga pa ga re sa re,
ga 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 pa ga re re ga pa ga pa, pa ga da da pa, pa ga da pa ga pa ga re sa re san no,
san no,
ta ya ya ya,
ta ya ya.
So sing the charanam 3-4 times before you go to the first swaram. At least 2-3 times it has to be sung. Only then the swaras have to be rendered. And each swara leads you back to the charanam. Let's do that again. Again, it should not be like that will be pretty crude. That ending of that finishing ga, so that it leads up to that third swaram seamlessly. Last time finish in sa. This is because the fourth swaram starts with the high sa. So finishing the lower swara will be a good musical step to lead up to that.
Sa di ga di sa di sa.
Sa di ga di sa di sa.
De sa de pa.
De sa de pa.
Ga di sa di.
Ga di sa di.
Sa.
Sa.
Sa sa di di ga ga.
Sa sa di di ga ga.
Again, see how the sa is playing. Re is oscillated both times and ga is alone given the spuritam.
Sa sa re re ga ga.
Sa sa re re ga ga.
Pa pa da da.
Pa pa da da.
So the treatment of that sa and pa is similar to that of re and da. Re and da you are oscillating both times. Sa and pa you are rendering plain both times. So generally in many ragas, you'll see these kind of relationships being similar between the first and the fifth note or first and fourth notes. If it is ga, then the ni also will be treated similarly in ragas which are having symmetric kind of phrasings. So you start observing these kind of things, then it will be easier.
Sa sa re re ga ga pa pa da ya da.
Sa sa re re ga ga pa pa da ya da.
Then normally this fourth line, fourth swaram, the first line can be repeated. It will sound nice if you repeat that. Go back to that once and once more and sing it.
Sa sa di di ga ga pa pa da ya da. Sa di ga di sa di sa da sa da pa ga di sa di sa. Sa sa di di ga ga pa pa da ya da.
Sa di ga di ga di. Sa di.
Da sa di sa di sa.
Da sa di sa di sa.
Pa da sa da sa da.
Pa da sa da sa da.
Ga pa da pa da pa.
Ga pa da pa da pa.
Di sa da pa.
Di sa da pa.
Ga di sa di.
Ga di sa di.
So let's sing the full swara.
Sa di ga di sa di sa da sa da pa ga di sa di sa. Sa sa di di ga ga pa pa da ya da. Sa di ga di ga di da sa di sa di sa pa da sa da sa da ga pa da pa da pa di sa da pa ga di sa di sa no pa ga 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 ga.
So like that, be well defined about the finishes. Srinivasa will complete the lyrics and then come down to sa nicely in an aesthetic manner and finish that. And then the other important thing is, because we are learning this varnam in Mohanam, doesn't mean that we should forget all the other geetams that we have learned before. Very, very important. Whatever we are learning at whatever stage, all the previous lessons should be well embedded in our minds. And we should be able to sing them at will. So, whenever we have learnt something, sing it several times so that you are able to cross-match, cross-refer to the kind of oscillations and other important features of the raga so that you are always on top of it. And remember all these compositions and learn as many compositions as possible in the raga. All the best.